Glitter.
Stars.
Twerk. And.
Bow.
Even.
I see myself happily married to Christina Bud.
And I see myself happily married to Jazz Mason.
Hey, my name is Garrett Ferguson, and in 10 years I plan to be on Malibu Beach.
In 10 years, I see myself doing my occupation, which is a physical therapist. Definitely have a family by then.
My name is Amanda Vishon, and in 10 years, I see myself being married to Garrett Ferguson on Malibu Beach.
I see myself in 10 years celebrating the 10-year anniversary of you asking me that question.
Y'all don't really want it.
fire. Girl, a quick fix and give your man a nice shiner. You know y'all don't really want it. And I can tell just by looking at you that you just like to run and go and tell just by looking at you. You want a mission for recognition by dissing. Didn't have no problem till the record started flipping. But y'all don't really want it. So let me tell you the deal. I'm also serious, I'm dirty, I'm no longer for real. I'm like a hop, skip and a jump, a clock grip on the pump. From leaving you in the trunk, somewhere prepared to dump. But y'all don't really want it, so quit acting like you dare. I'm looking to my right, trying to see who's there. So you better watch it before I stick to the plan and be the next artist to run up in your stands. Like, ooh, yeah, here comes the ooh, here comes the ooh, here comes the ooh.
storms and darkness flees. I'm reminded on that day, the last shall be, the first shall be, the last shall be, the first shall be.
Stand up for yourself. Rise. Blast on the quarterback.
Blast on.
Blast on.
Blast on.
Which blast?
Hi seniors, this is Coach Frost. 2011, a little bit of advice. Always think for yourself. Always vote your conscience. And beware of smiling faces that tell lies. Have a good life.
I'm with Sam Wolfolk of the golf team, and we have a couple questions for him. Sam, how long have you been playing golf?
I've been playing golf since freshman year when I started playing golf. My dad, he's always played golf, and I started playing with him and picked it up and liked it.
How do you feel about the season so far?
I felt like we ended it pretty good. We made it through district strong, won that, and got to regionals and just kind of fell off a little bit, but I thought it was a good season to end on for me.
Sam, how competitive is a sport at a high school level?
At a high school level, I mean, it's still pretty competitive. Kids get real serious about it. I mean, we had one kid one time just almost got into a fight because someone wrote a score down wrong. It's pretty competitive.
Okay, so what has been your best experience with the golf team this year?
Probably just being around the whole team. As a group, it's just really cool because we're all so close with each other. And probably just like messing around with coaches and stuff is really fun.
I see that you got your golf jacket on, so what do all these medals mean?
This is the one you get for the first year you're on the team. It's a golf bag, and I only got one of these right now. I'm supposed to get two more. It's for like each year you're on the team.
Mm-hmm.
But I hadn't got around to getting those yet.
Okay, well, good to know, man. Okay, Sam, we've got one last question for you. You got any shout-outs?
Shout-out to Jake Vincent. Hopefully next year he can still pull through and do as good as he did this year. And Weston Thompson, he did pretty good this year. And shout out to Kayla Young for coming in at the end of the year.
You got the idea of being a cornerback?
You know, growing up playing football, it's something I always liked. I mean, when I grew up, I was watching Deion Sanders play. I just wanted to be like him. I just put the football in my hand. I knew I was going to play cornerback. It's something I love doing.
Any other cornerbacks in mind? Maybe a Nnamdi Asamoah or some of these big guys you're seeing nowadays, Dominique Rogers, Cromartie?
Well, my favorite cornerback of all time, he played cornerback for the New Orleans Saints right now, Patrick Robinson. But I also like Darrell Revis. I try to idle him on Fridays all the time. I like the way he played, real aggressive, physical.
Colleges in mind, like any colleges reach out to you, scouts, anything?
Well, as far as right now, recruiting-wise, I'm getting recruited by Jackson State, UT Martin, Louisiana Tech, Louisiana Lafayette. Ole Miss, they doing little recruiting, but they're not recruiting as heavy as other schools recruiting me.
Nicknames. I wanted to get to this topic right here.
Well, you know, everybody like easily remember me by Paco. Everyone calls him Paco, so I feel like that's an easy name to remember. It's something similar to the cornerback for the Cincinnati Bengals named Pac-Man. So
yeah. Your other teammates, Jordan Barnes, Drew Thomas, Tony Cox. What are you looking at them in terms of leadership?
Man, they big leaders on the football team right now, man. Without them, I don't know where we'll be at right now. Drew Thomas, he show up big for the offense. Tony Cox, he show up big for the front on defense. Man, they just made leaders, man.
On JB.
Yeah.
That's why you look at him.
Oh, man.
In the future.
Man, every day in one-on-ones, me and him, we go at it. And that's what give me the hardest times in practice in one-on-one. He's so quick off the line, man. I think like in the near future, you know, him coming up being a senior, man, he'll be a big leader for the team and possibly a big leader for the wideout, somebody that the wideouts can look up to.
Drew Thomas, body like a big wide receiver.
As you tell him, man, he pretty big, you know. In practice, I never get a chance to like really go against him, but the times I do, man, he feels good. He put a body on you. It's pretty much he going to get the best of you.
Yeah. If he's a wide receiver, who would you compare him to?
Ryan receiver, I say Brandon Marshall for the Miami Dolphins. Big, physical, tall.
Okay, I gotta get to this topic.
Hey, I splashed on the quarterback. I splashed on.
It's actually called the song by Soulja Boy, Splash, Ocean Game, and Jazz Mason. He actually started saying in practice, and ever since then we've been saying it.
What are you seeing Jazz Mason particularly?
Particularly, man. Man, really, man, Jazz Mason, man, he's a hoss out there on the field, man. He do some unpredictable things. He big, fast, stop the run, he can cover a little bit. Man, Jazz Mason, everything you want in the linebacker. You know, and just by him practicing the game, why just sit back and watch Jazz play, make big plays, he kind of remind me of Patrick Willis for the San Francisco 49ers.
Any juniors that you're looking forward to that might have a breakout season and hopefully pick it up in college?
Well, I am looking for Reuben Branch. He a receiver also. I think he have a good spring this year. He'll pick it up more, get more physical. And of course, Justin Boren and Mario Hampton, man. I just can't wait to come back and watch the game and see them play, man. They're gonna be awesome, man.
You have a particular team in mind you would like to play for, or you just waiting for whoever drafts you?
Well, I do have three favorite teams in the NFL right now. But I can see myself playing for the New Orleans Saints or the Atlanta Falcons.
Yeah, it's nice talking to you, man. It's nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you too, man.
We'll be right back. receiver or a tight end?
Well, freshman year, I played quarterback for the freshman team for about 2-3 games, and then after about two or three games, I started moving up, practicing with the varsity, because Adam Poole was the starting quarterback at the time, had been hurt. So I played my freshman year. I started as a quarterback my freshman year one game. Decided to move me to wide receiver to use me, so they could just use me instead of me just staying on the sideline. Linebackers are usually more physical, so they either line up at linebacker or safety. But this year I've had entirely double coverage. I've gotten double teamed every single game, except for one game, which I scored 2 touchdowns that game. It is a big matchup problem. So, and it definitely helps with the run game, having to be able to block. So,
what were you thinking last year that you're thinking, who's going to take up the leadership role the next coming year?
Well, I'd say last year we had a lot of vocal leaders that didn't necessarily stand out on the field. I mean, they played, they started, they did their job on the field. They were very vocal. They got the team ready. Everybody rallied around them because they were very vocal, very, very animated characters on the field. This year we have, I mean, we still have vocal leaders. We have, I'd say, less vocal leaders, but I think our senior class this year is strong both mentally, physically, and, I mean, emotionally when it comes to football. I think they say the things they need to say at times, but when it comes to playing on the field, that's when they show their leadership. It shows through their play. I mean,
yeah.
You can only say so much, but once you get out on the field, it comes down to who's playing. I think our seniors really show out on game day. They're not always just vocal leaders. They do perform on Fridays. I think Justin is progressing. He's growing up as a football player. Little Justin out there. He'll never be as good as me. That's a shout out to Justin. But yeah, he's definitely doing work Fridays. At the beginning of the year, he caught for lots of yards. He's had lots of yards during games, but what he doesn't realize is you have to score. Yeah. And he's actually starting to learn how to score. He had 3 against Bolton. He had 2 the week before that, I believe. I think he's the second leading scorer on our team now, actually. Yeah. I think his senior year is going to be big. Obviously, last year he wasn't starting the first game. He actually ended up coming back starting after a big game versus Overton. We ended up losing it, but it should be bigger than his sophomore and his junior year combined. Yeah. So I think he'll do really well. He'll have good talent at receiver. I think the line will give him enough time. So
yeah, when you look at tight ends or wide receivers in the NFL, which stands out to you that you could match your skills with?
I think Gonzalez for the Falcons. Yeah. I think he's by far the best tight end to ever play the game. I don't think anybody will ever get anywhere close to that. But I'd like to think of my game maybe a little bit like Jason Witten, or probably more so Dallas Clark, how Indy uses Dallas Clark in the slot a lot.
Coach Wiley.
What he's done the last 3-4 years, that's all I can say is because those are the only years I've been here. But from the 1-9 season we had freshman year to, I mean, we had an undefeated season. We went 1-9 to 10-0. I mean, that's probably
the biggest. Yeah, I heard his job
was on the line. Oh yeah, I mean, obviously, his 1-9, his job's going to be on the line. But going from on the line to there's no way he's going to lose his job in 1 year. Undefeated district champions, first time we've ever won district championship for our school is with. With Coach Wiley, he's gone. I mean, he's made my senior class, the class of 2012 for football, is the most winning class in Arlington history, which would be the 3 years. I have the 1-9 season on my record, so it's not as good as all the, like, Tavian or Jazz who played just the last 3, their sophomore, junior, senior. I have the freshman, so I have the 1-9.
Coming into this year, was your team having that expectation, like, we made it, but we have to take the next step that we did that 10-0 season?
Yeah, we obviously wanted to go undefeated. We had a tough loss against Oakland the first week, which we wanted to schedule a harder schedule this year. In our first two games, I think Oakland at the time was seventh in the state. It was a tough game, losing the first game of the playoffs. We're not satisfied with one win in the playoffs. We're not satisfied with three wins or four wins. When we hit five wins, we will be satisfied because we will bring a state championship to Arlington. And that's what we want. We want to bring a state championship to Arlington.
One particular guy, maybe it would be Jazz Mason taking that, or Tony Cox on that defense. That's like the yapper mouth or something. But he bats that big with his play on the field.
The yapper mouth of the group is definitely Jordan Barnes. He's gotten an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty in every single game he's been in since he's been back. But he definitely runs his mouth, but he has backed it up so far on the field. I'm not big into the running your mouth. Against Bolton, I got cheap shotted. That makes me mad. That could ruin a chance of me getting a scholarship. But other than that, I'm not really going to say anything unless you, like, that obviously deserves me saying something to him. I'm not going to tell you exactly what I said because there's cameras, but I definitely had some words with him. But other than that, I think the play should talk for itself.
Yeah, it was nice talking to
you. Oh, yeah, thank you.
Who is your favorite teacher, Ronnie?
I would have to say Miss Cinderella, just because she's a funny, she's spunky and cool and funny. I love her.
We are here with
Bianca Woods.
And Bianca, who is your favorite teacher and why?
Dr. Christian, because she's really smart and funny and she's a good teacher.
I'm here live with
Brianna Orozco.
And who is your favorite teacher and why?
Probably Dr. Christian, because I love the way she teaches. Everyone can relate to it. So.
We're here with
Nicholas Palmer.
And who is your favorite teacher and why?
Well, it is definitely Coach Wiley, because I've been his TA for 2 years now, and I could just sleep or play video games on the computer.
And who is your favorite teacher and why?
My favorite teacher is Miss Stephanie Gonzalez, because her room's right there and she can hear everything I'm saying.
We're here with
Samantha Oyong.
And who is your favorite teacher and why?
Mr. Hudson, because he gave us candy when we had to write essays.
We're here with
Omar Yusuf.
And who is your favorite teacher and why?
Mr. White. He's just the realest teacher on the block. Smart.
I think that the most fashionable teacher at Arlington is Miss Dixon, because she always dresses very cute and there's never a day that she is awful.
I think that Morgan Reese is the best dressed girl in the school. The way she puts all her stuff together and all the attire and accessories she puts on.
I'm Katie Bowman, and I think Mr. Cantrell is the best dressed man at Arlington because of Bow Tie Thursdays.
Hi, my name is Bob Bishop, and I think Crystal Park is the best dressed because he just kind of has that swag.
Number two, and I think I'm the best dressed at Arlington.
Hi, my name is Ms. Perigin, and I think that Ms. Dixon is the most awesomely dressed lady walking around the halls of AHS.
Hi, my name is Chris Carter, and I think Coach Frost is the best dressed, hands down.
The person who I think is best dressed is myself, of course.
Hey, Arlington. My name is Ellis, and I think best dressed should go to Leslie Kimberly.
I'm Taylor Hallahan.
And I'm Hannah Hill.
And we think that Ms. Perigin is the best dressed.
Yeah, with the corduroys and the pigtails.
Okay, I'm Kayla Kidd. And I think the best dressed person is Zach Cormack, because he's not afraid to look like a picnic tablecloth or a weatherman, and he's always confident doing it, and you can wear whatever you want, and as long as you're confident doing it, then you look good.
I'm going to Mississippi State, and I'm going to major in architecture.
What are you gonna do after that?
Go to grad school at probably at Mississippi State.
I have just the answer for that. There's several options. I do very good at
Well, I'm going to Mississippi State University. I am doing the Air Force ROTC down there. I'm studying mechanical engineering.
All right, I want to go to Memphis, be a tattoo artist, or maybe a model for Calvin Klein.
Yeah. Affliction modeling for the Affliction brand of clothing. I have the perfect body for it.
All right. I am going to go to college. I'm going to major in biology with the intention of going pre-med, and then I'm going to go to graduate school to become a doctor. I think I'm going to become a dermatologist.
People say I have a lovely speaking voice. I could do
cover girl.
Many different commercials, voiceovers for various things.
I'm either going to go to the Naval Academy or the Air Force Academy, and probably major in biology or chemistry, and after that, hopefully go to medical school, and after that, start my own brewing company in California.
Probably Mr. Kerr, he doesn't teach anymore, but we should just like talk a lot and have like a lot of really cool conversations, and like we would this sounds like lame because he's a teacher, you know, but like we used to like share a lot like about mutual experiences and stuff like that, like, and like he's just been through a lot and he was really great advice.
Definitely have to say that Coach Frost is the one teacher I'll always remember because of his swag and because he's the only teacher has ever said I'm going to get hit by a counter.
There's been a teacher who's impacted me the most. I think it's going to have to be Mr. Wilhite, just because I got him in 10th grade for world history, and the way that his class was structured kind of hit me at first because it's just notes after notes and notes, and he kind of taught me organization, and pretty much I noticed it after like the year after that. I adapted to it in all of my other classes without even knowing it.
The teacher that has impacted me most, I'd say, would have to be Miss Manning, because once you get to know her, she's a really sweet lady, and she's very funny, and she's just a fun person to be around.
The teacher that impacted me most throughout my high school career has been definitely Mr. Joel Wilhite. I had him freshman year for Honors World History. Although I might not have done too well in his class, he was always very kind and he told the most amazing jokes. He got me through that little, you know, 1 to 2 o'clock hump every day.
I think that Mr. Riddick's probably the teacher that I will remember most, just because I've spent 4 years with the man and it ends up being like, I think 2 months worth of me spending in that room just listening to him and singing and all that. So yeah, he's definitely going to be the one I remember the most.
And the teacher that has most influenced me of these 4 years of high school is probably Miss Vannucci. She was the lady that was a stickler for English and writing, so now she's the one that's taught me how to write effective papers and communicate effectively throughout my entire life thus far.
And the teacher who has most influenced me is Miss A, because she's taught me so much in theater and just in life in general.
play the background. I could play the background. Cause I know sometimes I get in the way. So won't you take the lead, lead, lead. So won't you take the lead, lead, lead. And I could play the background, the background.
Now I love that song. Whenever it comes on, it makes me feel strong. I thought I told her that we won't stop till we back cruising through Harlem. These old blocks is what made me, saved me, drove me crazy, drove me away, then embraced me, forgave me for all of my shortcomings. Welcome to my homecoming. Yeah, it's been a long time coming.
Thank you.
I'm not afraid to die.
Emily Nicole Hugo. Kevin Oshiro Doe. Samantha Ying Zen Oyan. Elizabeth Lee Chisholm. Wait a minute. This is my script for May 25th. Class, Beauty and Beast. Formerly the most attractive couple at the high school. Class, Beauty and Beast this year. Amber Rankin. And Jazz Mason. Now, these are our best thespians. You voted. Here they are. Kelsey Blackwell. And Luke Enzor. Most likely to make history, formerly most likely to succeed. This was a landslide in both categories, both sides. Emily Hugo and Kevin Doe. Most likely to become the next Picasso, our most artistic students. You voted, here they are. Rashida Momo and Kramer Hollenbach. Most musically inclined, Emma Bailey. And Crystal Hart. Prettiest Pearly White, the best smile, Lauren Colvin, and Dorf Barnes. Most likely to make you smile, most likely to brighten your day, Tristan McKenzie. And you stand? Most likely to sweat Gatorade, our most athletic kids here. Landslides. Ariel Hearn. Alvin Dixon. All right. Where are we? Most likely to bleed blue and gold, most school spirited. Hannah Hitzfeld. And Matt Ferguson. Most likely to make you die laughing, the most comical seniors for 2019. 2012, Simone Hawkins. And Alex Flower. Best dressed this year for 2012, according to the senior class, Allie Menti. This is Mr. and Miss Arlington High School for 2012. McKinley Doty. And Brady Bradley.
Thank you. lots. For centuries, they have provided people with a place to park their cars while attending various functions. But today, we're here to determine the answer to an age-old question. Are parking lots friend or foe? Hi, I'm Kyle Worley, reporting live for ATV.
What does the parking lot mean to you?
I think that the ugly cars should just leave, because the pretty cars, like mine, are all that matter, and the ugly ones just ruin it for everyone else.
Wait, please, can we interview you? Please. I've noticed that I see you here at the parking lot quite a bit. What is it that keeps you coming back for more?
I don't really know. I mean, I guess I don't really have a choice. Why are you doing?
Clearly, there is more than meets the eye in this parking lot.
Excuse me, ma'am. Would you mind telling us a little bit about what's going on here, you know, like, aesthetically?
I'm just gonna go get in my car. I'm just going to my car.
And some people have a more personal connection to the parking lot.
Well, I mean, what I think, it's not about one lot or another. It's not about the senior lot or the junior lot. It's just about all the lots, just separating the gap between them, uniting everybody into one giant parking lot. That's what I believe in. That's what I stand for.
This man, known to the locals as Shaboy Parking Lot Daddy, has been coming to the parking lot religiously for 30 years.
The parking lot, to me, it's just that one place I really feel, you know, welcome. Like here, I'm really wanted. And but I don't really own a car, but it's like here is home.
Well, Arlington, you've heard the facts, and now it's time for you to decide. Is the parking lot really a friend or a foe? I'm Kyle Worley, reporting live for ATV.
Hey Sam, look what I invented.
What are they?
It's a smart chip.
Can I try one?
Yeah, sure. Oh, wait. We need a control. What do you think about the weather?
The weather's bad. It's not good at all.
Okay. Now with the chip. Now tell me what you think about the weather.
I'm inspired to believe that based on the evidence of the season.
What is she saying? Oh my gosh, I don't understand. Shake your head. The song stuck in my head. Oh, she's talking to me.
Do you concur?
Yeah, I concur. Hold on. Yes. Affirmative, I do concur. In fact, I believe that this luminous...
Yeah? Wait. What is he talking about? What the heck? Oh, so boring. Oh, what's in my hair? Oh, interesting.
And therefore, I find that spring is the most transcendent season of the entire year.
What?
I guess the effects wear off fast.
What effects?
The... What?
What?
What were we talking about?
I don't know.
Oh, hey, Chips. Can I have one?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, this is so awesome. I know everything. Oh, I lost it.
testify I'm never drinking Pepsi again.
How is your doctor's appointment?
Oh, so apparently I bruise easily. How messed up is that?
Wow, that's weird.
Yeah, so apparently no more theater or biking or... Are you kidding me?!
See, look, you don't bruise easily. They just want all your money.
Yeah, not now, but wait 5 minutes and my face will be as blue as the Facebook logo. Stop, man! Stop! Buddy! Stop! Stop! Seriously, man? Forget you, I'm leaving. And I'm taking my water. Zach.
Hey.
Whoa.
Why are you wearing sunglasses?
Why am I wearing sunglasses? I told you I bruised easily.
Oh, I didn't know.
Now let's see how easily you bruised!
Episode of Luke Eating Fruit. Today's episode, banana. Don't forget to tune in next week for a brand new episode, pineapple.
Oh God! Oh my God! Oh!
Hello, and welcome to another episode of Luke Eating Fruit. Today's episode, lemon. Don't forget to tune in next week for a brand new episode, strawberry smoothie.
It's fruit flavored.
Has anyone seen my smoothie?
Hey! So prom's coming up. April 7th? At the Esplanade. In Cordova. What are you gonna do? Step 1. Find a date. Step 2. Buy your tickets and turn in your prom contracts in the cafeteria. Step 3. Brush up on those dance moves. Step 4. Get dressed. Step 5. Make some dinner reservations for the big night. And then it's time for prom.
So don't miss out on the big night.
From 7 to 11.
At the Esplanade.
Word.
I don't see how you can hate from outside of the club.
You can't even get in.
Leg out. Yellow model chick, yellow bottle sipping, yellow Lamborghini, yellow top missing. Yeah, yeah, that shit look like a toupee. I get what you get in 10 years, in 2 days. Ladies love me, I'm on my cool J. If you get what I get.
First, gotta find me. What's 50 grand to a motherfucker like me? Can you please remind me? Ball so hard, that craze. Y'all don't know that, don't phase. And as we go, 0 for 82. When I look at you like that, you look gravy. Ball so hard, where? We ain't even Pope be here. Ball so hard, since we here. It's only right that we be fair. Psycho, I'm LiBo, to go Michael. Take your pick, Jackson, Tyson, Jordan.
Tomorrow.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen.
Shake that.
Girl, she on the jock, huh? Now stop when we in the spot. Booty moving weight like she on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Tight jeans, tattoo, cause I'm rock wrong. Half black, half white, diamond low. Gang of money, open door.
Yeah, I'm running through these halls like Drano. I got that devilish flow. Rock and roll, no halo. We party rock. Yeah, that's the crew that I'm repping. On a rise to the top, no letting our Zeppelin. Hey.
There's good and bad in all of us. It doesn't matter how far you run. There are some demons you just can't escape.
I need your help. This child is in danger.
Daddy! I don't save people.
If you don't help, the devil could have a new form. One more powerful than he's ever known. And a shadow will fall upon the earth. Save the boy and lift your curse.
I've made a lot of mistakes. But Danny's the one good thing I ever did.
That being the case, we better make sure he doesn't turn out to be the Antichrist.
The rider's going to come out. He'll destroy whoever's got it coming.
I'm not afraid of you.
You should be.
If I walk away now, I'm just trading one demon for another.
Plus, I have some personal issues I'd kind of like to get fixed.
The rider's coming.
Hell yes.
Introduce my mother-in-law, Clara, my wife, Michelle, and my daughter, Sylvia.
Whoa,
Where's the rest?
Never met the quota.
My units are up from last week.
So is the quota.
Just once, I'd like to wake up with more time on my hand than hours in the day.
How old are you?
28.
I'm 105. But the day comes when you've had enough. If you had as much time as I have, what would you do with it?
Sure as hell wouldn't waste it.
Last time anyone saw him alive, there was over a century on that clock.
Well, follow the time.
His name is Will Salas.
You can't hide 100 years in the ghetto.
You know that time will get you killed.
Hey, Mom, I'm gonna get out of here.
I just wouldn't know what to do if I lost you.
I don't believe we've had the pleasure of your company before, Mr. Salas. Will Salas.
I'm sorry to have to break up the party, Mr. Weiss. I just need a word with your friend.
This is my destiny.
Please take me home.
You can't do that.
Why?
You're keeping me alive. Yeah, this is my intention. How can you live with yourself watching people die right next to you?
You don't watch. You close your eyes.
I'm gonna make them pay. I'm gonna take them for everything they've got.
Come on, help yourselves.
Take the time, it's free.
You put enough time in the wrong hands, you upset the whole system.
Let's hope so.
If this works, we gotta get more.
I can help you get all the time you want.
You know we're coming to get you.
Will, look out!
His crime wasn't taking time. He was giving it away.
Who are we? We are no one.
Our mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activity on Earth.
Flacco! You know you're not supposed to be north of Canal Street.
Who is Flacco?
Just relax, punk. You're looking for me, not you.
Crazy, right? Two grown men talking to the wall talking back. It's a mess. But hey, don't even worry about it.
Incident report.
Access denied.
There are things out there you don't need to know. That's not the lie you told me when you recruited me.
I promise you the secrets of the universe, nothing more.
Well, what other secrets are there?
Kay!
I'm looking for Kay. Have you seen him? Sort of a surly older gentleman. He smiles like this.
Kay has been dead for over 40 years.
Here, take this.
Now all you have to do is jump.
You want me to jump?
Time jump.
Okay.
How do you know my name?
How did you get out there?
Fire escape.
It's 20 stories.
Your doorman's intimidating.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, Mr. Parker.
Not much to tell, really.
Peter lives with his aunt and uncle. Did you catch that spider guy yet?
No, but we will. This guy wears a mask like an outlaw.
I think he's trying to do something maybe the police can't.
Can't?
You know, if you're gonna steal cars, don't dress like a car thief.
You a cop?
You seriously think I'm a cop? In a skin tie, red and blue suit.
Who are you? I know it's been rough for you, Peter.
I forgot all about that thing. It was your dad's.
Your father was a very secretive man, Peter.
Dr. Connors. I'm Richard Parker's son.
Your father and I were going to change the lives of millions, including mine. Extraordinary. How did you come up with this?
There's a rumor of a new species in New York. It can be aggressive if threatened.
I gotta stop him, because I created him.
That's not your job.
Maybe it is.
Thirty-eight of New York's finest versus one guy in a unitard. Woo!
If you want the truth, Peter, come and get it.
I am issuing an arrest warrant for the masked vigilante known as Spider-Man.
Oh, I'm in trouble.
Started. And we are hopelessly outgunned.
Director Fury, I think it's time.
You here with a mission, sir? Trying to get me back in the world?
Trying to save it.
Doctor, we need you to come in.
What if I say no?
I'll persuade you.
What are you asking me to do?
It's called the Avengers Initiative.
I thought I didn't qualify.
Apparently I'm, what is it? Volatile, self-obsessed,
and don't play well with others.
I think they need a timeout.
Are you? And you call on such lost creatures to defend you.
You have made me very desperate.
We're not a team. We're a time bomb.
This is nothing we were ever trained for.
Guys,
I'm bringing the party to you.
Are NBA champions, the first title in franchise history.
Freeze in the air to center. Has he done it? Way back. Hello, game seven. Goodbye.
Richardson.
breaks free on the sideline. End zone. How about that? Finally, a touchdown between these two.
And here we go. First snap of the overtime. The Broncos have been in three overtime games this year. They won them all.
Got him at the 40. It's Thomas at the 50. Skipper got him three to the 30. To the 20. Thomas to the 10. Gilbert's going over the New England. They win it on the first play of overtime.
Four-man rush. Eli throwing into traffic on the sideline. They had a rule to catch by Manningham.
This is absolutely brilliant.
And the New York Giants, given the last rites by many in December, are the Super Bowl champs in February.
Body is ready. say that you only meant well, well, 'cause you did what you say. That it's all for the best, 'cause it is what you say. That it is what we need. You decided this, what you say.
Zach, we're never gonna find my bag.
I don't know, Kyle, I just can't. Wait! I know who we can call.
Nah, we can't afford them.
Well, then what are we gonna do, Kyle?
We can call the B team.
Did somebody say? The B team?
But this new B team, that's where it's at.
Somebody lift my backpack.
Got it.
Right, please.
Wow, they sure did find our bag.
Thanks, B team.
That'd be $1.
Justin, what's wrong?
Well, somebody dared me to sing a horrible song in everybody at lunch, and I've never done that.
Opera?
Yeah.
Okay, you know Samir?
Yeah.
He's a professional opera singer.
No way, really?
Yeah. Yeah. And he can teach you.
Really?
Yeah.
Good job. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Samir. You're the only person I know. I need you to teach me the ways of opera. Please.
You want me to turn you into an opera singer? Overnight, just like that. That's not how it works, Justin. That's not how it works. I once spent an entire summer in Malaysia just mastering my technique. And you want to do it overnight? Are you kidding me? Who do you think you are? No, I'm not gonna help you.
Please.
Yeah, I'll help you.
Okay. If you're gonna sing opera, we're gonna have to fix this. Alright, so first, leg out, hand up, head to the corner. There's your prize, it's right there. Voice, project!
Yes.
We're gonna have to work on that too.
Right, let's get you on this side because you're just bothering me.
Okay, show me what you got.
La 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 la.
Really? That's what you're doing? No, that's crap. All right, here we go again. This time, I want you to put so much feeling into it that you just want to burst into flames. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just everything you got, just right here in the gut. Just bring it out and let it sing with you. Oh, come on, let's do this. Do it again.
La la la
la.
That was perfect. That was wonderful.
Now, go forth and train your voice. Your dare is only a week away. Make sure you're ready.
I will. Oh yes, I will. Some kid, some punk, dared me to sing this Harry Potter song in an opera voice. In front of everybody at lunch. So, me being the good kid that I am, I'm going to participate in said dare. All right, let's do this. Opera time.
No singing.
What?
At all. Go. Shoot.
Okay, where is this? In the study hall. We're going to the study hall.
Study
hall. Woo!
All right.
Woo! Oh, what? Oh, what? Oh, you already are.